interrupt our regularly scheduled programming to bring you this local Pueblo sports broadcast. This is CSU Pueblo Thunderwolves basketball on Fox Sports Pueblo, 1350. Let's head courtside and join the voice of the pack, Jim Brooks.
Good evening, everybody. Welcome to Lockridge Arena on the campus of Colorado School of Mines. Beautiful Golden, Colorado. So you're set to bring you this pivotal RMAC doubleheader here tonight. Thunderwolves on the road to take on the Ore Diggers. The Ore Diggers first place in women's play. Thunderwolves in second, right behind them, two games behind them. So a crucial game if the Thunderwolves have some hope of winning the conference title here tonight. You got to feel like they got to sweep the two games they have against Mines coming up this year. They lose tonight, they go three games behind them. With half the season to go, it'd be a tough nut to crack to get back into it and try to win the conference title. So that's what is on the line, of course, here tonight in this ball game. This School of Mines club, they come into the game here this evening on a roll, to say the least. They are on a school record winning streak right now, as they haven't lost since the first two games of the season. And that goes all the way back to November 13th and November 14th, when they lost to West Texas A&M, got shellacked in that game, 65-42, then got pummeled even worse against Arkansas Fort Smith by 29, 76-47. So you're wondering, where is this club going to go? But then they had two more games in the preseason to get things straightened out. They knocked off Johnson and Wales and then Western Oregon. And then came a string of games where they just continually to win close game after close game. The conference opener against Colorado Christian, they won it in overtime by one, 64-63. A week later at Fort Lewis, they win a squeaker there, 57-56 on the road. Had a relatively easy game against Adams State, but then they defeated Colorado Mesa in overtime. Followed that up the next night against Westminster, winning by two. Then they went on the road to Western New Mexico, one by one. You start to get a definite theme here. A week later, here against Fort Lewis, they won by two, 65-63. Then most recently last week, a nail biter at UCCS, winning it late 59-55, and then a good close ball game against Metro State. And pretty much a rout when you consider the way their conference season go. They end up winning the ball game by seven. So they've won a number of close games this season. They could just as easily be sitting in the middle of the pack the way this conference shapes out. But right now in the Mountain Division, they are 11-0 and just easily could be 6-5, perhaps 7-4. Thunderwolves are at 9-2. They are in second place. They are a game ahead of Colorado Christian. Colorado Christian, by the way, will be tomorrow night's opponent. So this is a huge weekend for the Thunderwolves. If they could somehow sweep the weekend, they would get some distance between them and Colorado Christian. Plus, they would get right on the bumper of Colorado Mines in this Mountain Division in women's basketball. The rest of the Mountain Division looks like this. Fort Lewis, they've fallen on hard times here of late. They're all the way down to 5-6 right now. Western New Mexico at 4-7. So these two clubs we're going to see here tonight, Mines and CSU Pueblo, they're pretty much firmly entrenched as far as the shootout goes later on in the season. They want now to solidify their position and get home court advantage, or perhaps even host the shootout on down the road. On the other side of the ledger in the Rocky Division, Black Hill State, they are 9-2, and they have a two-game lead over Mesa, UCCS, and Regis. Metro State, South Dakota Mines, and Chadron State all sit a couple games behind them. They are tied for fifth place at this point. Westminster rounds out the Rocky Division at 3-8. Looking forward to the men's game a little bit later tonight as well. It's also huge because CSU Pueblo and Mines, they both sit at 7-4. They are tied for third place, a game behind Fort Lewis, two games behind New Mexico Highlands. So both games here tonight, huge implications on just the way the RMAC is going to shape out for these two institutions is the way it goes down, particularly for the men. The men desperately need a win if they want to hold out any opportunity of winning the RMAC. For the women, Mines, they win it, they got to feel like they've got a huge advantage, the three-game lead with just 10 games to go, and you'd feel like they'd have it pretty much sewed up. Thunderbolts can win it, gets them right back into talk of a league title. Thunderbolts with a huge win last Saturday against Black Hill State, a game they won in overtime. Remember on Friday night, they kind of laid an egg at home against South Dakota Mines. They kind of learned a lesson that you have to play hard each and every night, even though against teams that are in the middle of the pack. If they come in and want to beat you, you got to match their intensity level, and that's something the Thunderbolts didn't really do last Friday night against South Dakota Mines. They did do it against Black Hill State. They were very competitive throughout the ballgame, and in fact, after falling behind in the fourth quarter, turned it up a notch and actually won the ball game in overtime. So it's probably good for them to win a close ball game. They haven't been involved in that many super close games this year, so it's nice to get a win against Black Hill State. And as we've mentioned, Mines, they're well schooled in close ball games. You look at all the games they've won that have been one possession games, and a couple of those in overtime. But all that said, maybe they're due for a little mid-course correction here. Maybe Luck's going to catch up with them, but we'll see. One thing to watch tonight for the Thunderbolts, they haven't won a game this year where they've scored under 60 points. And that's something that Mines specializes in, their defense. They only give up 60 points a game, so that might be the magic number here tonight for the Thunderbolts. Get to 60, you got a good chance to win. If you fall short of that, then the tide's going to have to change. Thunderbolts will have to have come up with a win when they're below that threshold, but we expect a hard-nosed game here tonight. Both teams are kind of sitting at 1-2 as far as the conference goes in defense. Thunderbolts only give up 56 points a game. Mines, they give up 60 a game. So we could see one of those fights here tonight, or perhaps Thunderbolts can get their shooting eye going and maybe have their way with this ball club. But it all remains to be seen. I think that's one of the key numbers to watch here tonight in this game. See if it turns out to be kind of a high-paced game in favor of the Thunderbolts. It turns into a street fight, and you got to feel like it might be a little bit of an advantage for Colorado Mines. Mind you, the game's on television here tonight. If you, we, of course, want you to stay tuned here to Fox Sports Pueblo, and you're out driving around, but we'll remind you the games are on television, on Comcast Entertainment Television, and you're always welcome to watch the ball game, but turn down the sound and keep it listening. Tuned in right here to Fox Sports Pueblo. Other action going on in the conference tonight. Since we have an extended pregame here, we mentioned, of course, we're here to do this game. Our travel partner, Western State, they are over in Lakewood. That's where the ball club is staying, right off of 6th Avenue, and that's where we'll be tomorrow night to take on Carter Christian. They're playing host to Western State tonight. Other games, Mesa's in Denver here this weekend. They take on Regis. Westminster, they are in Shadron, Nebraska tonight to take on Shadron State. UCCS is at South Dakota Mines. Metro State is at Black Hills State. New Mexico Highlands is in Alamosa to take on Adams State. And Western New Mexico in Durango tonight to take on Fort Lewis. And we'll keep you up to date on those games all night long. And ones to watch, of course, for the Thunderbolts will be that Carter Christian game. And then on the men's side of the house, it's just a jumbled up mess when you look at things. We'll be keeping an eye on that New Mexico Highlands Adams State game. I think that has a chance to be a pivotal ball game on the men's side of the house. And interested to see just how Metro State fares tonight against South Dakota Mines and UCCS at Black Hill State. We saw how good Black Hill State is last week, so we'll keep an eye on that one as well, and keep you up to date on all the scores in the RMAC tonight. Big hockey game going on as well tonight in the Denver metro area as the Avalanche take on the Blues, and we'll keep you posted on that game throughout the evening. We're going to take this time out. We'll come back. We'll talk to the head coach, Jim Turgeon. That all comes your way next. This is the Thunderwolves pregame show on Fox Sports Pueblo. Welcome back to the Thunderbolts pregame show, and joining me now, the head coach, Jim Turgeon. And Jim, this is big game might be the understatement of the year. This is a huge game.
It is. It's a big game. It's You know, the first place team in our league, they've won 13 straight, 11-0 in the conference. It's on the road, so it's going to be tough. But if we could get it, it'd be really a big step towards a possible RMAC championship.
We'll bounce back to last week. I think last Saturday night's victory was a good stepping stone to win a close, hard-fought ball game like that.
Well, I hope we learned a lot from last weekend. I think we learned on Friday that what kind of, a team that really wants to beat us come in, we have to play at that same type of intensity. And then Saturday, I think we figured out, just how hard you have to play and have that fight to win every night out. And we beat a good team with a lot of injuries, and I just could be proud of our team for that game.
Well, let's touch on the injuries right away. Just run down them and see how everybody's doing. First with Dee Arrieta.
Dee's a little gimpy, but she's going to start and she's going to play. She's a tough kid. I wouldn't expect her to be down at all. T. Anderson, she's got a pole growing. It's more like a stretch. She actually looked good yesterday in practice, so hopefully nothing will happen there. And then we're still a week away from Angie playing, but she went 5-on-0 this week, so that's a positive step. And then we don't know about Megan yet. We're still waiting on MRI stuff on her knee, but we're ready to play. We'll take the group we got and do the best we can.
Well, last week winning that close game in overtime, you're facing a club here tonight. I mean, every game it seems like it's right down to the wire. They've won a number of one possession ball games. It's kind of uncanny. They could be just as easily probably be 6-5.
Well, they really could, but they just don't beat themselves. And that's what I told the girls this week. They're not going to give it to us. You have to go out and beat this team, and nobody's done it yet. Their talent is good, but they just don't make mistakes, and we have to go out and beat them.
Well, things people haven't been able to do against them this year seems like score. Seems like they're holding everybody down, and they're winning those close, low-scoring ball games.
Well, that's interesting because when you look at the RMAC stats, like their first in rebounds, we're second. Defensive field goal percentage, we're both of our teams are up there, and points per game, we're both up there. So this might be an ugly game. I hope it's not, because if it's not an ugly game, I think it's to our advantage. But it could be because both teams play really good defense.
Well, then with that said, and they like to slug it out, do you do anything special going over the top of them a few times or pressure them?
Well, maybe. We're kind of play it by ear. They're so smart. And again, I've seen other teams press them, and they just don't turn the ball over. So I think it's more of our, I think we're going to play our normal good defense. It's more of our offense. We're going to have to break them down a little bit, spread them. If we can, we're going to try to spread them out a little bit and create some lanes to drive and kick it outside for hopefully some open threes. But we got to play inside out. That game last Friday, we played outside in, and that doesn't work. And if we can play inside out, we might have a chance tonight.
All right, good luck tonight.
All right, thank you.
All right, Thunderbolts head coach Jim Turgeon back with the starting lineup's opening tip-off. All comes your way next on Fox Sports Pueblo. Welcome back to Lockridge Arena here on the campus of Colorado School of Mines here in Golden, Colorado. Always great to get up here to Golden. It's such a beautiful area here, kind of the gateway to the Rockies. And if you can just get around the traffic, everybody had to battle that. Thunderbolts had to battle that a little bit here getting in here. They usually arrive here about an hour and a half before game time, and it was about 5:05 when I first saw their faces come in here. So I know they got hung up in a little bit of that metro diversion. I got caught up in a little bit of on C-470 down south, as you always do. Right when you get off I-25 and you hit C-470, it's a parking lot, even at 3:30 in the afternoon, until you get past about Santa Fe, and then it kind of loosens up until you get around I-70, and then you just kind of roll on in here to Golden. So not that bad at all. It's kind of like a homecoming here tonight at Lockridge Arena. Of course, assistant coach for Colorado Mines, Leslie Haywood, former assistant coach at CSU Pueblo, and she's made the move up here a few years back. Well, it's been 4 years, I think, now that she's been up here at Colorado Mines as a brand new baby, so everything going well with her. And Jenna Drown is in attendance here tonight, has made the trip to Denver to see some of the old friends. Of course, the wife of the former head coach, Kip Drown. And she's here tonight visiting her daughter, as well as taking in the Thunderbolts basketball games here tonight and tomorrow when we make the trip on over to Lakewood when we take on Carter Christian. So always good to see some familiar faces here tonight at School of Mines. They expect a pretty big crowd in here tonight. They support their ball club pretty well. And why wouldn't they? They're very good, and this is a nice little friendly arena to come in and watch. And the students tend to get into it a little bit, especially in the men's game. So we expect kind of a raucous house here tonight at Lockridge Arena. Well, you heard Jim Turgeon, or if you didn't hear him, if you're just joining the broadcast here, expecting us to be started. We're getting started a little bit late here tonight. The game being televised on Comcast Entertainment Television. The women's game shouldn't be affected that much because they're not going to do the usual media timeouts like we'll have in the men. We'll have our usual media timeout at 10 minutes of each half. And the men's game, of course, are going to do it at 16, 12, 8, and 4. So we'll have some extra timeouts in the men's game, so that'll drag on a little bit. But the women's game should roll pretty much as usual. And so shouldn't expect too many problems at all getting this game underway. Mentioned Mines, they're a good defensive ball club. They hold teams down to 60, but they only outscore them by 3. 63 to 60 is their average on the year. You'd expect it to be more with a team that is 13-2. But that just tells you how many close games. Plus, you factor in those first two games of the year when they got really creamed, when they lost by 23 and another game by 29. That kind of skews that stat a little bit. Thunderwolves, they outscore their opponent by 11 a game, 67 to 56. So if there's an advantage, maybe in this game, it's for the Thunderwolves there. They make a couple more three-pointers a game. Both teams rebound the well. Thunderwolves are plus 6 in that category. Mines is a plus 5. Turnovers, both teams turn the ball over 15 times a game. Thunderwolves tend to force more turnovers. Mines forces 4 less turnovers a game. So Thunderwolves maybe perhaps a little bit of an advantage there. We'll just have to see how it shakes out there. Shooting percentages, Thunderbolts shoot at 40% a game. Mines, they shoot it at 39, so we're fairly even there. As we mentioned, the Thunderbolts, they make 1.5 three-pointers more a ball game. Average 5.9 hits a game, where Mines only hits 4.3. But we saw what can happen last week with South Dakota Mines. They hit a bunch of threes. We'll come back. We'll have the starting lineups right after this on Fox Sports Pueblo. Welcome back to Lockridge Arena. Let's give you the starting lineups for tonight's ball game. First for the Thunderwolves, they'll go this way. D. Arrieta, 5'4" senior out of Pueblo West, averaging 6 points, 5 rebounds. The game leads the team in assists, averaging 3 an outing. Ashley Piper, 5'10" senior out of Cedar Rapids, Iowa, 8 points, 6.5 rebounds. The game coming off a 16-rebound effort last Saturday night against Black Hills State. Tule Sue Anderson looking to bounce back. Groin pull last week really hurt her ball game, and that game against Black Hills State was held to 2 points, a season low. She comes in. She's a 5'8" sophomore out of Vancouver, Washington. 15.5 points, leads the team in that category. 3 rebounds a game, also averages 2 assists. Lauren Hines, 6-foot freshman out of Loomis, California. 10 points, 7.5 rebounds a game. And Molly Rohr, the leading shot blocker in the RMAC. 6'2" freshman out of Greenwood Village. Went to Cherry Creek High School, averaging 11 points, 5 rebounds a game. The head coach, Jim Turgeon, in his first year. Mines go this way. It'll be Laura Tyree, 5'6" junior out of Lakewood, Colorado. Cassidy Budge, 5'8" freshman out of Colorado Springs. Caitlin Smith, 6-foot sophomore out of Thornton, Colorado. Courtney Martin, 6'2" senior out of Parker. And Anna Cole Morgan, 5'7" freshman out of Des Moines, Iowa. Brittany Simpson is the head coach. Our officials for tonight's game, Thomas Motz, Randy Powell, Justin Matchburn. I don't know which one is which, so it won't really matter, will it? Thunderbolts in their road blue, red numerals, white trim. They'll move it right to left as we look at it. We sit courtside, just off center court here, kind of next to the Mines bench. Mines controls the tap there in their home white with the gray numerals. At the top, D. Tyree works around a screen, hands it off on the right side to Smith. Down low on the block, turnaround shot on the baseline is up, no good. They've got position for the rebound to go up, shot blocked from behind by Rohr. Get another try, they missed it. Another try, they lose it, and it goes to the baseline, and they save it. So they're going to get a fourth try here on this possession. Here's Tyree on the right wing for the Oerdiggers. Dribbles around the screen, going to pop a three-pointer short, and this time Piper gets the rebound. So 4 tries, 4 misses for the Oerdiggers on their first possession. Up top, Piper goes up to Hine, onto the right side to Anderson. Tule Sue working around the screen, steps back. She's going to fire a long three-pointer. In and out, no good, and the rebound on the baseline to Martin. gets the outlet pass to Tyree, and she'll work it across the timeline to the top of the key. Goes onto the right side with the ball there. This is Emily Bailey. Goes down, a little turnaround shot, no good. Rebound to Piper in the lane off the miss. And the outlet pass on the left side to Arietta. Up top to Piper to Rohr. Onto the right side to Anderson. Anderson looking inside, drives to the free throw line, down the lane she goes, has the ball stripped away and stolen by the Oerdiggers. Back the other way comes Bailey. Bailey holds things up, Piper went for the steal, couldn't get it. Tyree will bring it across the timeline to the top of the key. He'll stop there, looks to the high post, goes to Martin on the block, hands the ball off to Tyree, and she'll back out of there to the three-point line. Now lobs it down inside, turning, Martin goes up, left-hand hook, missed it, and the rebound to Lauren Hine. Ice cold start here for the Oerdiggers. Thunderwolves one miss and one turnover. Here's Arietta at the top of the key. Gives it off to Piper. Piper directing traffic. Got to do something with it. Now gives it to Rohr. Onto the right side to Arietta. Down to 12 on the shot clock. Up top to Piper. Piper fakes, drives to the free throw line. Cut off, steps back. Can't get the shot off. Goes to Rohr. 5 on the shot clock. Turn around, left hand hook up and in. Molly Rohr. It's the Thunderwolves off to the 2-0 lead to start this ball game. Ball on the right side. This is Cole Morgan. Lobs it down on the block. Martin turns. Can't get the shot off. Goes to the baseline to Smith. They swing it around up top to Tyree. Now down underneath. Nice pass shot up and good by Emily Bailey. Good work there by the Oerdiggers to tie the thing up at 2 apiece. Arietta across the timeline. Up top to Hine. Right side to Piper. Piper on the wing. Has the ball batted away. Regains it. Now goes up top to Tule Su. Left hand dribble to the wing. Has the ball knocked away. And it's saved and stolen away by the Oerdiggers. Back the other way comes Tyree. Tyree with Arietta to beat. Down the lane. Left hand hook. Missed it. But they get the offensive rebound and a push. And knocked out of bounds. Tule Su Anderson picks up the foul. Tule Su is going to get the quick hook. Beagley into the ball game. And Mariana Lambert into the game for the Thunderwolves. Hine comes out as well. 2-2 our score. 7:23 to go here in the first quarter. Inbounds pass comes to Tyree. Works it to the free throw line to Smith. Now underneath, there's a right-hand hook shot. No good, but a foul on Rohr. That's Courtney Martin. That's who they want to run their offense through. And every time she's got it, it goes up. First foul of the game on Rohr. Two team fouls on the Thunderwolves. That'll send Courtney Martin to the free throw line. 70% free throw shooter. First toss on the way. It's good. Gives the Oerdiggers their first lead of the night. She'll have one more. Senior out of Parker. And missed that one. And Thunder will save the rebound. It comes outside and it's knocked free and the Oerdiggers get it. Up top to Tyree. Onto the right side. Back to Tyree. She sets, fires for three. Got it. So it turns out to be a four-point possession for the Oerdiggers. They lead it 6-2, 7 minutes to go here in the first quarter. Arietta up top to Beagley on the right side to Lambert. Now to Piper. A lot of quick hands out there by the Oerdiggers. They swat it at every chance they get. Beagley goes inside to Rohr, turns outside to Piper, can't get the shot off, drives into the paint, has the ball stripped away. There's those quick hands again as the ball is stolen, but then dribbled off the foot out of bounds by Cole Morgan, and it goes right back to the Thunderwolves. Thunderwolves going to have to be a little bit stronger with the ball here. They've had a lot of balls knocked out of their hands here in this game so far on the strip. Here's Arietta on the left wing. Get up on her. Now to Piper. Piper turns, wheels down the lane, and a blocking foul on the Oerdiggers. No shots on the play. The foul came before the shot. The foul on Paul Morgan. First team foul on the Oerdiggers. Martin out of the game, and into the game comes Elizabeth Tolman, a sophomore out of North Ogden. Very young ball club for this Oerdigger club. Piper inbounds, gets it in to Rohr, and she missed the banker. And the rebound underneath to Tolman. Gets the outlet pass to Tyree, brings it across the timeline, onto the right wing. Gets a screen, and the ball batted away from behind by Arietta. So a little turnaround as well. Now they're going to say, okay, initially they signaled Thunderwolves ball. There's no way that could be the fact. So now they overrule. End of the ball game comes Cassidy Budge for the Oerdiggers. They lead it 6-2. Inbounds pass to Tyree. Stops, goes down on the block. Here's Tolman. Feeds it on the left wing. Three-pointer on the way. Good. By Cassidy Budge. She comes off the bench firing. 9 in a row by the Oerdiggers, and they lead it 9-2. 6:05 to go here in the first quarter. Arrieta at the top of the key. The post now. Roar outside Arrieta. Fires the three-pointer. In and out, no good. And the rebound underneath the Budge. It's the outlet pass to Tyree. Fires it ahead on the right wing, driving the baseline. Cole Morgan goes inside, can't get the shot off, hands it off outside, faking the shot, driving the lane. Budge feeds it to the baseline, fake, drive the baseline, now into the corner. They work it around the perimeter. There's another three-pointer by Budge, another one good. Timeout taken by the Thunderwolves. 12 in a row by the Ore Diggers. Has them on top. 5:37 to go here in the first quarter. 12-2 Mines. It's a 30-second timeout on Fox Sports Pueblo. We're getting a good indication why this Mines club is so good. And they've won 13 in a row. Now they send the teams back to the bench. Well, the official gave conflicting signals. He gave the old 30-second timeout, and then he spread his arms out wide. So he's now explaining himself over to the side. Well, why don't you just say it that way instead of going through all the histrionics? But, you know, referees will be referees. Now the teams come back out as we wait for television to get out of their timeout. So Thunderwolves here, trailing by 10. Tule Sue back in the game. Arrieta brings it across the timeline to the top of the key. Gives it off to Arrieta. Now to Tule Sue Anderson. Lost it. Stolen away by the Ore Diggers. Back the other way comes Tyree. Tyree feeds it into the corner. Nicole Morgan, she drives the baseline. And it looked like she walked. No call. Ball's loose in the lane. And the Thunderwolves had it, lost it, tied up. Alternating possession belongs to the Thunderwolves. Lauren Hine now will check into the game. And Molly Rohr out for her first rest here of the first quarter. Arrieta brings it across the timeline for the Pack. They led it 2-0. They haven't scored since. Tule Sue on the wing. Goes right side to Lambert. Lambert looking down low. Can't find anybody. Goes to Hine at the top of the key. Left side to Arrieta. Up top now to Lambert. Nothing working here. Great defense by the Ore Diggers. 10 on the shot clock. Tule Sue fakes. Now drives to the free throw line. Cut off. Now drives back in. Goes into the corner. Arietta's open. Three ball on the way. Off the iron. No good. Rebound batted outside. And it's picked up by the Ore Diggers. As Budge gets it ahead now to Tyree. She brings it across the timeline to the top of the key. Hands it off outside to Toman. On to the left wing. Now they skip it cross court to Tyree. Down on the block. Here's Toman. Turns. Comes outside to Tyree in the corner. Skips it wide open on a shot. Blocked by Tule Sue, but she picked up the foul. Coming over to help out. And that'll be the second foul on Tule Sue Anderson. And it'll send Cassidy Budge to the free throw line to shoot a pair. First free throw up and good. Cassidy Budge, 73%. As a team, they're only 64% on the year, are the Ore Diggers. They're 2-for-3 so far in this game. Second toss, rims in and out, no good, and Hine gets the rebound. 13-2, Mines on top. Ball on the right side. Here's Lambert, works around a screen to the free throw line, down the lane, dishes off to the baseline to Beagley. Don't take the shot, goes outside, now to Lambert. Lambert gives it off now to Jasmine Johnson, who's into the ball game. To Beagley on the left side to Arrieta. Down low to Hine, in the paint, goes up with the right hand hook, left it short. And the rebound to Tyree, she'll bring it across the timeline. Working on Arrieta, goes down the lane, pulls up, missed the layup, rebound to Lambert. Lambert gets the outlet pass to Arrieta. Arrieta pushing the pace now. On the right wing, stops, won't pop, goes up top to Beagley, left side to Lambert. She's open, three ball on the way, way off the mark. It's an air ball, and the ball goes out of bounds. It'll belong to the Ore Diggers. And into the ball game, Caitlin Smith for the Ore Diggers. And Toman comes out. Also in, Katie Kuhn. Junior guard out of Laramie, Wyoming, brings it across the timeline. She'll run the point, hands the ball off on the right side to Budge, works around a screen, stops, goes left side to Bailey, down on the block, turning, facing, right hand hook, missed it, and the ball batted away out of bounds, last touched. They say by the Ore Diggers, I think it was last touched there by Maddie Beagley, but the officials elected not to call the foul on Martin going over her back. It's kind of a push. Thunderbolts get the ball. Arrieta brings it across the stripe. Goes onto the right side to Lambert. Lambert holding it there. Up top to Johnson. Can't get the shot off. Drives into the paint. Goes up and under. Left hand. Oh, good on a foul. It'll count. What a move by Jasmine Johnson. She'll have a chance for the three-point play. That stops the run at 13. It was a 13-0 run by the Ordiggers. Johnson to the line. 75% from the line this year. Hits the free throw, so she completes the three-point play. Much needed for the Thunderwolves. Gets it within eight. It's 13-5. 3:05 to go here in the first quarter. Here's Budge at the top of the key. Comes onto the right side. Now they work it back left side into the corner to Budge. Now on the right side to Bailey. Work it over on the right wing. Now they lob it down inside. Turnaround shot up. Missed. Rebound loose. And traveling is the call on the Thunderwolves as Lambert got the rebound and then fell to the ground. So it's a turnover right back to the Ordiggers. Inbounds comes to Bailey on the baseline. Pops missed it. Rebound to Arrieta. She'll wheel and bring it out of there. Brings it across the timeline. Thunderwolves trying to cut into the lead up top. Now they go right side to Lambert. Lambert works around a screen to the free throw line. Down the lane, running left-hander, missed it badly. And the rebound on the other side to Martin. Outlet pass thrown away. It'll go right back to the Thunderwolves. So the Ordiggers a little careless. Jim Turgeon telling his ball goal, here's your chance right now to get back into this ball game. Rohr checks back in for the pack. And Beagley out. Lambert to trigger it in right in front of us here, courtside. Hits it into Johnson. Hands it off now to Shannon Patterson, who's into the ball game now for the Thunderwolves. Sophomore out of South High School. Ball on the right side, Johnson. Down low on the block to Hine. Turns, gives it off to Rohr. Left side, Lambert can't get the shot away. 15 on the shot clock. Little bump outside. Lambert hands it off now to Patterson. Patterson to Hine at the top of the key. Down low to Rohr. Turns in the lane. Goes up with the left-hand hook. Missed it badly. And the rebound on the other side to Bailey. Ball didn't draw iron. Bailey brings it across the timeline. Being worked on by Johnson. Gives it outside to Tyree. Works around a screen. Stops. Can't pop. Now goes down on the baseline. Martin wheels. Missed the layup. Rebound comes to the baseline. Little 10-footer up. In and out. No good. And the rebound to Hine off the miss by Cole Morgan. Outlet pass to Patterson. She'll bring it across the timeline. Up top now. They give it off to Hine. Onto the right side to Johnson. Johnson works around a screen. Steps back. Three-pointer on the way. And it's an air ball. Man, the Thunderbolts drawn a lot of air in this ball game so far. And here's the rebound. Tyree has it. She'll slow things down here with a minute 25 to go in a low-scoring first quarter. 13-5. Ordiggers on top. Ball out top to Smith. Drives to the free throw line. Hands the ball off to Tyree. Will pop the 15-footer. In and out. No good. And the rebound to Lambert. Gets the outlet pass to Patterson. Patterson brings it across the timeline. Fires it ahead to Johnson. Down on the block to Rohr. She lost it. Turnover. Back the other way come the Ordiggers. Tyree brings it across the timeline. To the free throw line. Down the lane. Stops from 10. Won't take the shot. They work it into the corner. Here's Cole Morgan. She shoots an air ball. Comes out the other side. Long rebound to Smith. Gives it off now to Tyree. 15 on the shot clock because it didn't reset because the ball drew nothing but air. Here's Tyree down the lane, running right-hander. Missed it badly. Late whistle foul. Offensive foul is the call on Laura Tyree. Ashley Piper back in for the Thunderwolves. And Mariana Lambert comes out. Johnson triggers it into Patterson. And Patterson will bring it across the timeline for the Thunderwolves. Dribbles to the left wing. Boy, a lot of bumping and jousting going on inside. They get the ball to Piper. She drives in, goes inside to Hine. Ball lost. It's on the deck. Now they call the foul on Piper. Foul on Ashley is her first. Bounce pass comes to Laura Tyree. And she'll hand it off now to Emily Bailey. Goes to the right side to Tyree. Turns, faces, lobs it down on the block. Bailey wheels, turn around, shot, missed it. Rebound for the Thunderwolves to Hine. Gets the outlet pass to Patterson. Patterson will race it across the timeline. Gets it ahead to Piper. Piper going to drive into the paint. That's going to be a block. Oh, my God, they call a charge. Unbelievable. Know your geography. Always Know your geography. Second foul on Piper. Here come the Ordiggers across the timeline. Dribbling down the lane. Feeded into the corner. Long three ball at the buzzer. No good. Thunderwolves with their lowest output for any quarter this season as they only put up 5 points. The Ordiggers lead it 13-5. 1 minute timeout on Fox Sports Pueblo. Our score at the end of one. Ordiggers on top. Thunderwolves 2 of 11. That's 18%. Mines 4 of 21. That's 19%. But the Ordiggers did hit 3 three-pointers in that first quarter. That's the difference in the game really right now. 9 extra points there. Thunderwolves go to a little press here to try to pick up the tempo. Here's a drive of the baseline. Cut off there nicely. Ball knocked away, goes out of bounds. Good defense on that side by Hine. Knocking the ball away from Emily Bailey. Inbounds pass comes in the lane. Tyree turns, fires, in and out. No good. Rebound batted outside. Thunderwolves have it as Patterson comes up with the rebound. Long outlet pass ahead to Arrieta on the wing. Stop and go. Drives the baseline up and under. Missed it, though. And the rebound to Bailey. It's the outlet pass to Tyree. She brings it across the timeline to the top of the key. Holds things up. Now on to the left side to Smith. Smith gives it off to Cole Morgan to the free throw line. Here's Bailey with the jumper. Missed it. And the rebound batted loose, and the Thunderbolts come up with it. Arrieta has it. She'll bring it across the timeline. On to the left wing. Gives it off to Patterson. To Rohr. Rohr on the right side to Johnson. Thought about the three. Drives to the free throw line. Down the lane. Running left-hander. Blocked. And it goes out of bounds. It'll belong to the Thunderwolves. 19 on the shot clock for the Thunderwolves. Trailing it here 13-5. Arrieta to trigger it in. Goes outside to Johnson. Thought about casting off. Couldn't get the shot off. Gives it off to Patterson. Fakes the three, and she walked with the ball. Inbounds pass. Comes into Tyree, and she'll bring it across the timeline for the Ordiggers. Now they play a little weave game out around the three-point line. Come on to the right side to Tyree. Down on the block, turning, facing. Double team, though, in place. Can't get the shot off. Come outside to Bailey into the corner. Here's a three ball on the way. Short, long rebound. Ball loose on the deck. The Ordiggers come up with it. Ball in the corner. Can't get the three off. Cole Morgan gives it off. Now to Bailey, way outside to Tyree. Now to Cole Morgan. She's directing traffic. Now they set up, ball handed off on the right side to Bailey. Now up top to Tyree. Stops and pops for three. In and out, no good. Rebound batted away. And again, the Ordiggers get it, but they lose it. Last touch, though, by the Thunderwolves. Ordiggers dominating the rebounds right now as they are a plus six in that category. Inbounds pass nicely. Layup. Good and a foul. It'll count. Got the inbounds to Smith. They set a nice screen for her, and she hit, and she'll go to the free throw line. And the foul on Hine is her first. Smith only 50% from the free throw line, and it shows why there. She missed that one pretty badly, and the ball batted away out of bounds by Martin, so it'll be Thunderwolves' ball. That broke a long drought there for Mines. They've gone 4 minutes without scoring. Remember, they led it 13-2 at one point. Thunderwolves haven't been able to cut into it much, though. So they trail it by 10 here, 15-5. Arrieta goes left side to Patterson. Patterson drives it into the paint. Gives it off now to Hine. Outside to Johnson, right side to Arrieta. Arrieta works around a screen to the free throw line. Stops, pops from 15. Got it. D'Arrieta let the defense clear and hit the shot. Her first bucket of the game. It's 15-7. Thunderwolves down by 8. Here's Bailey. Stop, pop, missed it, but nobody boxed her out. She followed it in and laid it in. That's just poor play by the Thunderwolves, the oldest fundamental in the world. Block out the shooter. And she just followed her shot in there and laid it in. It's 17-7. Ball on the right side to Patterson. Down low now to Rohr. Turns on the baseline. Goes up. Missed it. Missed everything. Johnson gets the rebound. Goes up with the right hand. Hook and banks it in. Jasmine Johnson, fearless inside, took it right at the big player and laid it in, 17-9, as she got it over the top of Martin somehow. Ball in the corner. Here's Cole Morgan. Is it up top to Bailey, into the paint. Martin turns, goes up with the left hand, hook missed it. Arietta with a rebound. She races it across the timeline to the left wing. Will stop there and pop for three. Off the iron, no good. Long rebound into the corner, and it'll go out of bounds, and it'll belong to the Ore Diggers. Anderson, Lambert, and Beagley going to check in now for the Thunderwolves. Huey Sue playing with two fouls. When she isn't scoring, the Thunderwolves really suffer on offense. No two ways around it. Here's Tyree on the right wing. Now up top to Smith, back right side to Tyree. They get it down a block, turn around, double team, missed the shot, rebound batted outside, but right into the hands of Kuhn, missed the banker, rebound loose, and lost out of bounds by Rohr. Thunderwolves finally got their hands on the ball, but couldn't secure it. Inbounds pass to the baseline. Can't get the shot off. Regaining a Tyree as Arietta almost had the steal. Comes outside to Kuhn. On to the right side to Budge. Now back to Tyree to the free throw line. High post ball batted away, but can't get the steal. Right back into the hands of Martin. Dribbling to the top of the key. Kuhn for three. Missed it. Anderson with the rebound for the Thunderwolves. She'll bring it across the timeline. Races into the forecourt to the baseline. Fakes, goes up. Missed the banker. Rohr with the rebound, and she banks it in. Molly Rohr with four, makes it 17-11. Thunderwolves back within six here with 6:10 to go in the first half. Here's Kuhn. Now up top to Smith. Smith lobs it to the high post. Turning, facing, can't get the shot off. Go left side, three-pointer on the way. Off the iron, no good. Long rebound. Lambert had her hands on it. Goes out of bounds. Last touch by the Ore Diggers. As missing the three was Cassidy Budge. So Thunderwolves here down by only six. Inbounds pass to Arietta. She'll bring it across the timeline. Gives it up top to Lambert. Lost it. Loose on the deck. Arietta, or Tuli Sue Anderson, dies for it. It's a tied up. Alternating possession belongs to the Thunderwolves. Tuli Sue Anderson to trigger it in. She'll get it into Arietta. Arietta onto the left side to Lambert. Lambert up top to Tuli Sue. She starts a drive to the baseline. Goes up right hand. Hook missed it. Rebound batted out of bounds. Last touch by the Ore Diggers. It'll be Thunderwolves' ball. It was a good move there by Anderson. Just didn't finish it. Anderson to trigger it in on the baseline. Gets it into Rohr. She's wide open. Goes up. Missed. But she was fouled hard. And she drew the foul on Courtney Martin. That'll be foul number two on Martin. Nope, they say just foul number one. I guess so. Only her first, evidently. Rohr only 44% from the free throw line this year, but calmly strokes that one in. We'll have one more. Thunderwolves as a team, 67% on the year. Average 12 makes a game. Second toss, good. Perhaps Molly did a little extra work this week. She looked pretty calm at the free throw line here. Thunderwolves have scored six in a row. They're within four. It's 17-13. It was pretty much has been an ugly ball game to this point. Mine's only shooting 18%, but the Thunderwolves shooting 25%. Here's Bailey down the lane. She goes up and under and lays it in. That'll get your shooting percentage up. Bailey with six. 19-13. Stops a 6-0 run by the Thunderwolves. Lambert on the left wing. Trying to get it to Hine. Down on the block. Wheels. Fakes. Goes up and banks it in. Lauren Hine makes it 19-15. 5:05 to go here in the first half. Here's Bailey on the right wing. Lobs it down inside to Martin. Turns. Gives it off outside. Three-pointer by Bailey off the back iron. Long rebound. Arietta has it. Dribbles to the right wing. skips it cross court to Tule Sue, fakes the three-pointer. She drives the baseline. She's in, but missed the layup. Rebound to Hine, comes outside to Arietta. Onto the right side to Tule Sue, up top to Beagley. Beagley comes left side to Arietta. Shot clock down to 11. Here's Lambert at the top of the key. She drives into the paint. Step back jumper on the way. It's an air ball. Rebound goes out of bounds. And we have a media timeout. 4:29 to go here in the first half. Thunderbolts hanging around here. They're within four. It's 19-15. Mines on top. 1 minute timeout on Fox Sports Pueblo. 15, our score. Stat sheet, ugly, to say the least. Mines 7-35 from the field. Thunderbolts only 6-23. Mines has hit 3 three-pointers. We're even in rebounds. Thunderbolts have turned it over 9 times. Mines only 4. So those 5 extra possessions, plus the 3-point buckets, helping Mines this little lead right now. Thunderbolts pressure in the backcourt. They almost get the turnover. Ball knocked loose, but it's picked up by the Ordiggers. They still have a chance for the trap. And now a whistle and a foul on the Thunderwolves. Foul going to be called on Hine. That'll be her second. Cole Morgan to trigger it in now for the Ordiggers. Lobs underneath, they go back door, and Tule Sue Anderson makes the steal and then draws the foul on Emily Bailey. Second foul on Bailey. That's the foul I missed earlier. I had given it to Martin, but instead it went to Bailey, so she has 2. Thought Tule Sue was kind of fortunate there. She didn't pick up her third, got the ball, and then she was fouled. Arietta across the timeline on the left side to Lambert. Up top to Tule Sue. Starts a drive. In from the right. Goes up and under. Missed it. Didn't get the foul call. And the rebound on the baseline to Tyree. She'll come out of there. Bring it across the timeline. Down the lane. Feeds it into the corner. Almost threw it away. But it's chased down by Cole Morgan. Now up top. Here's Martin. Goes underneath on the right side to Budge. Now up top. Now they go back underneath. Martin turns. Can't get the shot off. They swing it up top. Three-pointer by Tyree. In and out. No good. Rebound. Layup. Missed. Rebound loose on the baseline. Out of bounds. Last touch by the Ordiggers. Inbounds to Arietta. 3:35 to go in this second quarter. Thunderbolts only down by 4. Feel like they ought to be down by 20, but here they are. They sit down by only 4. Here's Lambert driving the baseline, draws the foul. Cassidy Budge draws the foul. That's her first. It's the third team foul on the Ordiggers. Remember, we reset now in women's basketball at the end of each quarter. We go back to 0 on team fouls. I like it. I think the game flows a lot better. Here's Arietta at the top of the key. Goes up top to Rohr. Right side to Arietta. Now to Anderson. Top of the key. Fakes the three-pointer. Drives up and under. Left-hand hook. Up. No good. And the rebound to Smith. Outlet pass to Tyree. In from the left on Arietta. Flips it cross-court. Shot foul from behind on Tule Sue Anderson. That's going to be her third. No, they don't give it to Tule Sue. That's a break for the Thunderwolves there as they call the foul on Lambert. Could have easily called that on Tule Sue Anderson. It would have been her third. So at the line, Cole Morgan, only a 64% free throw shooter, but she calmly strokes in the first. Averages 6 points a game. Freshman out of Des Moines, Iowa. Second toss off the back iron. Long rebound into the corner, and Beagley chases it down there for the Thunderwolves. 20-15, 3 minutes to go. Bad pass, but unable to save it across the way. Cassidy Budge for the Ordiggers. Tule Sue Anderson coming out right now, and Jasmine Johnson. I think that's a good move right here. I think Jim Turgeon kind of stole a call on that last possession. Inbounds pass to Arietta. Onto the right side to Lambert. Out to Johnson. Inside to Rohr. Wheels down the lane. Up and in. Travel is the call. The way Tyree at the top of the key, directing traffic Zone on the right side to Cole Morgan. Now up top to Smith. On to the right side to Budge. Work this weave game out around the three-point line. To Tyree into the corner. Fake the three. Go down inside. Nice dish. Coming down the lane. And the layup is good by Caitlin Smith. She has four. 22-15. Lead back to seven now for the Ore Diggers. Beagley onto the left side to Lambert. Lambert holds things up, gives it to Rohr. On the block, backs her way in, goes up, left-hand hook on the baseline, missed it. Lambert went over the top, didn't get called for it. Ball saved on the baseline, tied up, and Ore Diggers get it free. Outlet pass to Tyree. Tyree now bring it across the timeline. Under 2 minutes to go now here in this first half. Ball on the right side, Smith with it. Lobs it down inside, ball gets away, though, and it's stolen away by the Thunderwolves. Back comes Lambert. She'll bring it across the timeline. Top of the key, gives it off to Johnson. Johnson, one dribble. Kills it. Now gives it to Rohr. Now to Lambert. Johnson. Top of the key. Dribbles to the right wing. Down inside to Rohr. Backs her way into the paint. Left hand hook up and in. Molly Rohr with the left hand. She has eight. 22-17. Thunderwolves within five. A minute 23 to go here in the first half. Ball up top. Smith with it. Lobs it down inside. Wheeling going up with the hook. Good. Courtney Martin. That's her third point of the game, 24-17. Mines on top by seven. Arietta at the top of the key. Going to launch a long three. Swish! D. Arietta from way downtown buries it. 24-20. First three of the game for the Thunderwolves. Here's a drive of the baseline by Budge. Goes up. Missed it. Rebound to Lambert. Outlet pass to Arietta. Arietta brings it across the timeline. Dribbles to the left wing. Will stop there. Gives it off to Lambert. Up top to Rohr. Onto the right side to Johnson. Johnson dribbles around the screen to the free throw line. Goes outside to Lambert. Lambert holds it there. They're trying to get it down low to Beagley. Find her on the block, and she's fouled from behind by Caitlin Smith. That'll be the fourth team foul on the Ore Diggers. Patterson and Chandler Bobby into the ball game now for the Thunderwolves. Freshman out of Bennett, Colorado. To trigger it in on the baseline. Gets it into Bobby. On the wing. Comes up top. Bad pass, but it is knocked away and stolen by Tyree. And now the Ore Diggers can go for the last shot. Tyree at the top of the key. Gives it up top. Now goes on the left wing to Budge. Now gives it off to Cole Morgan. She drives into the paint. Goes outside. Now they feed it up top to Tyree. She's going to jack up a three ball. Missed it. Rebound to Bobby, and then she lost it out of bounds with 11 seconds to go. So now the Ore Diggers another chance at a last-second shot here. Tyree jacked up that three way too early in the possession, but the Thunderwolves let him off the hook. And the Bobby experiment is over. Arietta back in. Inbounds pass to Tyree. She dribbles around the wing. Down to 7 seconds to go. Tyree going to start a drive. Gets a screen down the lane. Feeds it in the corner. Three ball on the way. It's good. And there is the buzzer. Cassidy Budge finishes the first half with 10 points and gives the Ore Diggers a 7-point lead as they head to the locker room. Mines leads at 27-20. Nate Baptist with our halftime update. That all comes your way next on Fox Sports Pueblo. Welcome back to Lockridge Arena. Thunderwolves trailing the ball game 27-20. Let's give you the first half numbers here. Mines led by Cassidy Budge. She has 10 points. Bailey with 6. Smith with 4. Tyree and Martin with 3. Cole Morgan has 1. 10 of 42 from the field, only 24%. They were 4 of 14 shooting threes. That's 29%. And they only average 4 makes a game, so they're right where they usually are at the end of a ball game. 3 of 7 from the free throw line, 43%. Thunderwolves led by Molly Rohr, who had 8, Arietta with 5, Jasmine Johnson off the bench had 5, Lauren Hine with 2. 8 of 28 were the Thunderwolves, that's 29%. Only 1 of 7 shooting 3s, that was from about 25 feet by Arietta. 3 for 3 from the free throw line. Both teams even in rebounds, 28 apiece. Leading rebounder is Smith with six for the Ore Diggers. Hine and Arietta with five apiece. Lambert with four for the Thunderwolves. Thunderwolves turned the ball over 12 times in the first half. Mines turned it over only six. So six extra possessions there, kind of key, plus those three extra three-pointers. Really causing the problems for the Thunderwolves in this first half. Thunderwolves led early, 2-0. But then the Ore Diggers went on a 13-0 run, led it 13-2. Thunderwolves slowly got themselves back into the game. Gradually, they trailed 13-5 at the end of one. Got it within four on a number of occasions. At 17-13, again at 19-15, again at 24-20. But a three-pointer late in the first half gives the Ore Diggers the seven-point lead at halftime. We're going to take another one-minute timeout. One-minute timeout. Back with the second half right after this on Fox Sports Pueblo. And welcome back to Lockridge Arena. And the Ore Diggers will get the ball first to start the second half. They'll move it right to left as we look at it. We're still in the TV timeout here, so that's why they haven't let them go as of yet. Ball on the left side. Put the ball around the perimeter, trying to get it down low to Martin. Turns, faces, and hits. Martin with five. It's 29-20. The lead back up to nine now for the Ore Diggers. They've scored the last five in the game. Anderson on the left wing for the Thunderwolves. Up top to Arietta. On to the right side to Piper. Piper now to Rohr. Rohr left side to Arietta. Thought about the three. Can't get it off. Comes up top to Piper. She thought about the three. Can't get it off. Steps back. Goes left side to Arietta. Arietta going to jack up a long three way short. Rebound loose in the corner. And it goes out of bounds off the Thunderwolves. Tyree on the left wing, hands the ball off. Here's Cole Morgan, feeds it into the corner. Three ball on the way by Bailey. No good. Rebound to Arietta. She'll wheel and bring it out of there herself. Across the timeline. Over to left wing up top to Rohr. On to the right side to Piper. Piper gets a screen, dribbles to the free throw line, steps back. Shot blocked by Bailey. And she'll wheel and bring it across the timeline herself. To the free throw line. Stops. Hands the ball outside to Smith. Now gives it off to Tyree. Down inside. Martin turns. Wheels goes up with the left hand. Missed it. Rohr with the rebound. Outlet pass to Arietta. Arietta across the timeline. Fires it cross court into the corner to Anderson. Three ball on the way. Swish. Tule Sue Anderson, her first bucket of the game. And gets the Thunderwolves within six. It's 29-23. Ore Diggers on top. Ball up top to Smith. Smith goes backdoor. Nice pass. Shot by Bailey Smith. The layup. The rebound to Anderson. She'll bring it across the timeline herself. Onto the right wing. Starts a drive. Is bumped. Foul on the Ore Diggers. Foul will be on Cole Morgan. That'll be her second. Clueless fan behind me questioning the foul call. I mean clueless. They're supposed to be smart up here in Golden, I thought. Ball on the right side to Arietta. Up top now to Anderson. On the right side to Piper. Steps back, can't get the shot off. Now left side, Arietta. She's open. Three ball on the way. Off the iron, no good. Hine gets the rebound on the baseline. Saves it, but threw it away. Right to Budge. It's the outlet pass ahead. Ball knocked loose, but it's retrieved by the Ore Diggers. Now Tyree with it. She'll bring it across the timeline. Stops at the top of the key. Holds things up there with the left-hand dribble to the left side. Hands the ball off. They run the weave. Cole Morgan, free throw line jumper. Swish. Cole Morgan with three. 31-23. 8-point lead for the Ore Diggers. Hines up top to Piper. Piper gives it off to Anderson. Fakes the three. Bumped outside. Spins. Goes up. Free throw line jumper off the iron. No good. Rebound underneath. That's got to be a foul on the Thunderwolves on Hine, I believe. Had to either call the foul or call traveling on the Ore Diggers, and I think it was a pretty obvious foul call. Inbounds pass comes to Tyree. She'll bring it across the timeline, onto the left side. Cole Morgan, the Smith. Smith one dribble. And Piper just reaches right in, steals the ball away. It's the outlet pass to Arrieta. Fires it ahead to Hine, but pass was too low, and the ball was deflected. Hine was wide open for an easy one underneath. Back the other way comes Tyree. She dribbled it off her knee out of bounds. Last touched by the Thunderwolves, they say. The ball went off the knee of Tyree, but... Sean, if they've taught you one thing, know your geography, okay? Remember that. Know your geography. Inbounds pass. Here's Martin. Jumper good. And the botched call results in a bucket for the Ore Diggers. 33-23. 10-point lead for the Ore Diggers. Here's Arrieta at the top of the key. Holds things up. Goes down low to Roar. Turns outside to Arrieta. Up top to Tule Sue. Jab step. Can't get the three off. Right side to Piper. Down low to Roar. Backs her way in. Goes into the corner to Piper. She's going to launch a three. It's good. Three-pointer by Ashley Piper. Her first bucket of the game. 33-26. Thunderwolves within seven. Back the other way. Hand the ball off on the baseline to Smith. Smith goes back door, down the lane, Cole Morgan. Shot blocked by Roar, but the rebound to Martin. Ball knocked away by Hine, but it's last touch by Hine. It'll belong to the Ore Diggers. So it'll be Bailey across the way to trigger it in. Inbounds pass to Tyree. She's trapped. It dribbles out of it. Ball loose. That should be a walk. They don't call it. Ball on the left side to Smith. Now up top. Give the ball to Tyree. Four on the shot clock. Tyree works around a screen. Stops. Launches a desperation three. It's an air ball. That's got to be a shot clock. They don't call it, though. Rebound to the Thunderwolves. What's going on out here? Here's Anderson in from left. Draws the foul. And Tule Sue to the free throw line. Foul is on Emily Bailey. That is her third. That could be a key call in this ball game. Tule Sue Anderson to the free throw line. Been a bit of a struggle of late from the line. She's down to 74% now. Free throw up. Bennett rattles in. 4 points for Tule Sue. All of them coming here in the third quarter. Coming into the game. 33-27. Thunderwolves down by six. Sophomore out of Vancouver, Washington with one more. It's on the way off the back iron. No good. Rebound. Hine had it. Lost it. Taken away by Paige Husa, who's into the ball game now for the Ore Diggers. Hands it off to Tyree. Tyree races down the lane. Cut off. Plowed into Piper. No call. Piper on the deck. They come outside. Husa for three. Off the iron. No good. Piper with a rebound. Then she's hit hard from behind by Cole Morgan. That'll be the third foul on Cole Morgan. 13 foul on the Ore Diggers. Hine out. Beagley in now for the Thunderwolves. Piper inbounds the ball to Arrieta. 33-27. Mines with a 6-point lead. 5.5 minutes to go here in the third quarter. Tule Sue open for the three. Won't take it. Goes to Roar. Wheels goes up with the right hand. Hook and banks it in. Molly Roar with 10. 33-29. Thunderwolves within four. Tyree across the timeline. Picked up by Arrieta. Comes up top to Smith. Smith onto the left side. Paul Morgan. Drives around Tule Sue to the baseline. Cut off there. She's trapped. And then a whistle and a foul on a Thunderbolts. A reach-in foul here on Anderson. Had her trapped, but don't reach. And the foul on Tule Sue. Means she's going to have to come out of the game. And it'll mean Lambert in now for the Thunderbolts with 5:06 to go. Call Morgan now. Triggers it in to Tyree. Down on the block. They come outside. They work it around the perimeter. They call Morgan. Down inside. Martin wheels goes up. Shot blocked by Roar. That's the second block of the game for Roar. We've got our media timeout. 4:56 to go in the third quarter. Thunderwolves are within four. It's 33-29 Ore Diggers. 1 minute timeout on Fox Sports Pueblo. Heating up here in the third quarter at Lockridge Arena. Thunderwolves are within four. Ore Diggers have the ball, though. And we call Morgan to trigger it in. 20 on the shot clock. They get the ball in to Smith. Now up top to Tyree. Drives the baseline. Cut off. Feeds the ball outside to Smith. Back inside. Martin turns. Faces. Skips it outside to Husa. Into the corner. Work the ball around the perimeter. Tyree now 5 on the shot clock. Works around a screen. Step back 3 on the way. It's in and out. No good. And Lambert gets the rebound. How did that stay out of there? Outlet pass to Arrieta. Works to the left wing. Up top to Lambert. Now to Beagley. On to the right side to Piper. Piper works around a screen to the free throw line. Now drives into the paint. Walking is going to be the call on Piper. One thing's for sure in this game, there are going to be no bailout calls. You got to just accept it. You got to be a little stronger with the ball. Ball inside. Here's Martin wheeling in the lane, and she just threw it out of bounds. Again, you could have called a blocking foul there on Rohr, but the officials let it be known. They're not going to bail anybody out in this game, it looks like, at least at this point. Now, they could change on a dime, but right now, that's the way it is. So get your shooting eye primered from the outside. Here's Lambert up top to Piper. On the right side to Arrieta. Arrieta works around a screen. Feeds it up top to Lambert. Left side to Piper. Piper drives into the paint, and there's going to be an offensive foul on the Thunderwolves. An illegal screen on Lambert. Oh, the turnover gives it back to the Ore Diggers. Bounce pass to Tyree. She'll bring it across the timeline. Here's the ball up top to Smith. Ball knocked away. Piper has a chance for the steal, and she has it. Going to be 2-on-1 here. Piper in from the right, goes up on the baseline, missed the banker. Rebound area to a foul inside on the Thunderwolves. Foul on Beagley. And across the timeline comes Tyree. Gives the ball up top to Smith. Smith hands the ball off to Cole Morgan. Now to Tyree. Tyree holds it there into the corner to Cole Morgan. Down onto the block. Martin turns, faces, can't get the shot off. Comes outside to Budge. 10 on the shot clock. Step back 3. It's up. No good. Rebound. Batted around. Comes loose. Piper had it. Lost it. And the Ore Diggers get it. Smith hands the ball off to Tyree. Tyree works around a screen, way outside with it. Dribbles the left corner of the key, now hands the ball off. They run the weave game. Here's a jumper by Cole Morgan from the free throw line. No good. Arrieta goes in there, gets the rebound for the Thunderwolves. She'll bring it across the timeline. On to the right wing. Thunderwolves down by only 4 here. They go down low to Rohr. On the baseline. Turns. Can't get the shot off. Comes outside to Piper. Piper right back to Rohr. Foul over the top on Courtney Martin. Fourth team foul on the Ore Diggers. Each team with 4 team fouls at this point. 2:41 to go in the third quarter. Jasmine Johnson checks in. Beagley will come out. Jim Turgeon wanting a little more firepower out there. Inbounds pass. They get it into Rohr. Rohr on the block. Wheels. Backs her way in. Goes up with the left hand hook and lays it in. Molly Rohr with 12. Thunderwolves are within 2. It's 33-31. 2:30 to go here in the third quarter. Ball on the right side. Cole Morgan with it. Gives it off to Tyree. She starts to drive. Stops. Pops. Hits. Tyree with 5. Good move there. 35-31. Ore Diggers by 4. 2:10 to go in the third quarter. Arrieta across the timeline. On the left side to Lambert. Out top to Johnson. Johnson starts to drive. In from the right. Up and under. No. Ball loose. And comes into the corner, and Johnson gets it back to Lambert. Up top to Piper. Looking for Rohr. She's in the paint. Wheels goes up with the right hand. Good and a foul. It'll count. And the foul will be number 3 on Courtney Martin. And it'll send Molly Rohr to the free throw line. A chance for the 3-point play. Rohr coming into the game, 44% from the line, but has hit 2 in a row tonight. Spins it up and in. 15 points for Molly Rohr. Thunderwolves are down by only one. It's 35-34, minute 50 to go here in the third quarter. It just wouldn't be right if the Ordiggers weren't involved in a close game. They've won 13 in a row. Six games they've won on a one-possession game, two of them in overtime. So they're right where they want to be. Here's Tyree, feeds it into the corner to Smith. Hands the ball off to Tyree. Tyree works around a screen. Stops and pops again. This time missed it. Lambert with a rebound. Thunderwolves can get the lead on this trip. Arrieta will bring it across the timeline. Skips across court to Piper. She's open. Won't take the shot. Goes down low to Rohr. She's the hot hand. Can't get the shot off. Feeds it off to Lambert. She'll pop from 10. Missed it. Piper couldn't get the rebound, and Tyree has it for the Ordiggers. Brings it across the timeline to the top of the key. Nice dish to Smith. In from the left. Missed the layup. Rebound lost out of bounds, and it'll belong to the Thunderwolves. As Toman had her hands on it, but lost it. Tule Sue Anderson checks in. Lambert out. Kind of an off night for Mariana Lambert. It's been an off night for a lot of people tonight. But all it takes here is a good quarter and 57 seconds, and you could steal a game here. Arrieta on the right side to Anderson. Boy, Piper was there, just missed her. Now to Rohr, left side to Arrieta. 15 on the shot clock. Up top to Tule Sue. Fakes the three. Drives into the paint. Goes up and under and lays it in. Anderson with 6, 36-35. Only our second lead change of the game, and the Thunderwolves last led it at 2-0. Ball up top. Caitlin Smith with it. Looking back door, can't find anybody. Goes to Budge on the left wing. Budge into the corner. Down on the block. Backing her way in is Toman. Right hand hook. Missed it badly. Rebound. Piper has it. Hands the ball off now to Tule Sue. Last shot time for the Thunderwolves. They also get the first possession of the fourth quarter here. Give it off to Arrieta. 8 on the clock. Arrieta way outside. Looking for a screen. 4 seconds to go. Arrieta down the lane into the corner. Anderson for 3. In and out. No good. And the rebound to Toman at the buzzer. But all in all, the Thunderwolves did what they needed to do there in that third quarter. They outscore the Ordiggers by 8. They take a 1-point lead to the fourth quarter. They lead it 36-35. 1 minute timeout on Fox Sports Pueblo. We head to the fourth quarter. Thunderwolves lead it by 1. Thunderwolves up to 33% now from the field. Ordiggers mired at 24%. Thunderwolves now out rebounding the Ordiggers, but Thunderwolves have turned the ball over 7 more times. 7 extra possessions in this game from Mines. Thunderwolves by 1. They get the ball first to start this fourth quarter. Anderson on the right wing. Up top to Piper. Starts a drive. Down the lane she goes. Running right hander. Good. Piper with 5. Thunderwolves, their biggest lead of the night. 38-35. Ball on the right side. Budge with it. Goes down inside to Toman. Turns. Drives the baseline. Johnson goes in. Tried to steal it. They call it jump ball. Alternating possession belongs to the Ordiggers. Good alert play there by Jasmine Johnson. Lauren Hine checking in now, and Piper will come out for the Thunderwolves. Paul Morgan to trigger it in. Gets it into the corner to Tyree. Drives into the paint. Steps. Fires. And got the roll. Nice play there for Tyree. Makes it 38-37. Thunderwolves by 1 with the ball. Arrieta brings it across the timeline. Up top to Hine. Onto the right side to Johnson. Foul on the play on Cassidy Budge. She went for the steal. Got all the arm of Jasmine Johnson. Probably fortunate that she did hook her arm, if she hadn't. It was a clear-out situation. Johnson could have taken it in for the bucket. Tule Suda triggered in right in front of the Thunderwolf bench down the way. Inbounds to Arrieta. Arrieta. Way outside, now dribbles to the right wing. Now to Tule Sue, works around a screen. In from left, strip foul. Foul called on Paul Morgan. That'll be her 4th. That'll send Tule Sue Anderson to the free throw line to shoot a pair. Already 2 quick team fouls on the Ordiggers here to start this fourth quarter. Tule Sue to the free throw line. 1 out of 2 from the stripe tonight. Free throw up and good. She'll have 1 more. 39-37. One more for the sophomore out of Vancouver, Washington. Spins it up and in. 8 points for Tulay Su. It's 40-37. Thunderwolves by three. Tyree across the timeline for the Ore Diggers. On to the left side. They skip it up top to Budge. Budge holds it there. Drives around Johnson. Cut off. Hands it outside to Kuhn. Kuhn into the corner. Now up top to Tyree, and that's going to be a blocking foul called on Arrieta. Jim Turgeon wanted the elbow call there, but he wasn't quite there in time. I wouldn't have called anything. I thought it was just kind of touchy. Here's a foul inside on Hine, plowing over Tyree, who set the screen. Foul number four on Lauren. Beagley in, and Hine will come out. Trouble on the inbounds, but they get it into Tyree. Now down inside, Wheeling. Toman fakes, goes up, right-hand hook, missed it. Rebound, Beagley rips it down. It's the outlet pass to Arrieta. Thunderbolts a chance for their biggest lead of the game. Here's Johnson on the left wing. Thunderbolts lead it 40-37. Johnson onto the right side to Arrieta. Down low to Roar and threw it a little too far. Tried to lead her to the basket. And it sailed out of bounds. So the Thunderwolves turn it over. Has been their bugaboo tonight. 17 turnovers on the Thunderwolves. Four Diggers with just nine. Ball on the right side. Here's Budge. Comes up top with it. Now down low. Turning. Tyree left it way short. Rebound to Arrieta. Arrieta will bring it across the timeline for the Thunderwolves. Onto the left wing. Boy, this game just sitting there for the Thunderwolves to get hot. A couple of three-point buckets would just be huge in this game. Here's Anderson driving the baseline. Wheels goes up. Left it short. And the rebound to Kuhn. Outlet pass to Tyree. She'll bring it across the timeline. On to the right wing. Comes up top. Now to Smith. On to the left side to Budge. Into the corner to Kuhn. Kuhn, one dribble, two dribbles. Kills it. Now goes down on the block. Wheeling in the lane. Faking. Going up. Shot blocked by Rohr. Rebound Anderson, and she is fouled in the backcourt by Kuhn. Third team foul on the Ore Diggers. Well, mentioned when Bailey came out of the game, that's really when the Ore Diggers started the struggle. She's back in there now, redshirt freshman out of the Dalles, Oregon. Here's Arrieta at the top of the key. Dribbles to the right wing. Up top now to Piper. Dribbles around a screen, steps back. Here's one of those three balls. Off the back iron, no good. Anderson bats the ball outside. It comes loose into the corner, goes out of bounds. Last touch by the Ore Diggers. Good work there by Piper as she kind of out-muscled the Mines defender, ended up on the deck, and the ball went off her head out of bounds. Piper to trigger it in. Skips it into Arrieta. Arrieta on the left wing. Holds things up. Now goes to Piper at the free throw line. Starts to drive into the paint. Turnaround from the free throw line. Missed it badly. Rebound to Tyree. She'll bring it across the timeline. On the fly. Reach-in foul on the Thunderwolves. That prevented the easy breakaway there. I think the foul is going to be on Arrieta. It might be on Piper. Take your pick. They're going to give it to Arrieta. Third team foul on the Thunderwolves. We're even in that category. 7:02 to go here in the fourth quarter. Thunderwolves lead it 40-37. Budge to trigger it in. Gets it in on the outside to Bailey. Down on the block. Turn around. Hook up and in by Courtney Martin. She has nine. 40-39. Thunderwolves' lead has been chopped to one. Arrieta across the timeline. On to the right side to Anderson. Now to Beagley. Beagley holds things up. Goes right side to Anderson. Thinking about the three. Jab step. Drives the baseline. She's in. Shot blocked. But a foul. And that might be number four here on Bailey. No, they're going to call it instead on Budge. That'll be her third, and it'll be Tulay Su to the free throw line to shoot a pair. Free throw is up and good. 9 points for Tule Sue Anderson. It's 41-39. Thunderwolves by two. One more to come for the sophomore. Patterson checks in now for the Thunderwolves. Arietta out. Needs a break. She won't be on the bench for long. Second toss. Swish. Anderson with 10. 42-39. Thunderwolves by three. Tyree up top to Smith. Goes back to her. Ball deflected by Beagley, and that prevented an easy two as Bailey was in on the left side, but they couldn't get the pass to her. So now it'll be Cassidy Budge to trigger it in. Right in front of the Ore Diggers mascot, looking menacing on the baseline. Lob it inside. Here's Martin. Turns, faces, 10-footer, swish. Martin with 11. 42-41. Thunderwolves lead is one. Patterson on the right side. We're down to 6:10 to go here in the fourth quarter. Thunderwolves trailed most of the night, but they finally got the lead here. Here's Tule Sue down the lane. Nice move. Layup good. Anderson with 12. 44-41. Thunderwolves by three. Back the other way comes Tyree. Picked up by Patterson. Tries to dribble around a screen. It's not a very good one. They're trying to go down on the block. Martin again. Turns. Faces. Can't get the shot off. Gives it off to Tyree. Tyree works around a screen. Now fires it into the left corner. Three ball on the way for the tie. Swish. Cassidy Budge from downtown ties the game up at 44 apiece. 5:30 to go here in the fourth quarter. Here's Anderson on the right side to Piper. Skips it to Anderson. Fakes the three. Drives the baseline. Goes up and under. No good, but she drew the foul. The foul came before the shot, but it's not going to matter because they're over the limit. Foul is on Budge. That's her fourth. Ordigger's creeping into some foul trouble here. Cole Morgan with four, Budge with four. Martin and Bailey have three apiece. Of course, Hine on the bench with four for the Thunderwolves. Tule Sue has three. First free throw up and good. Patterson out, and as expected, Arietta back in after about a one-minute break for the stretch drive here. Tule Sue Anderson with one more free throw to come here. Spins it up and in. She has 14. 46-44, Thunderwolves by two. Tyree dribbles around a screen, hands the ball outside. Now they come up to the top of the key to Smith. Right side to Tyree. Tyree lobs it down on the block. Turn, face, shot, no, but a foul on Molly Rohr. Got a little too much of the body into Courtney Martin that time. Only the second foul on Rohr. That's pretty important. So Courtney Martin to the free throw line to shoot a pair. 70% on the year, one of two from the stripe tonight. First toss up, and it rims in and out, no good. One more for Courtney Martin. She's a senior out of Parker. And left that one short. And the rebound. Beagley lost it out of bounds. She had it in her hands and just dropped it on the baseline. Boy, in this ultra-close game, you just feel how critical that might be. Every possession like gold here down the stretch. Inbounds pass, and that ball's deflected. Piper makes the steal but can't secure it. And Arietta goes to the seal, doesn't get it. Bailey into the paint, goes up, shot blocked, rebound to Rohr. Thunderwolves not to be denied on defense on that possession. And now Arietta brings it across the timeline for the Thunderwolves. 4:50 to go here in the fourth quarter. Pack leads it by two. Up top, Piper starts a drive, steps back, can't get the jumper off. Now to Rohr, now to Anderson. Anderson on the left wing. Thunderwolves going with a kind of a high post offense, trying to get a cutter. Anderson step back, fires the three, swish! Tule Sue from downtown has 17. It's 49-44. Thunderwolves by five. Their biggest lead of the game. Tyree will bring it across the timeline. Going to hold things up. Thought they might take the time out there. They decide not to. They give the ball off to Smith. Onto the right side. Drive to the baseline. Here's Bailey. Had the ball poked away from behind. Goes out of bounds. Last touch by the Thunderwolves. Media timeout. 4:07 to play here in the fourth quarter. Thunderwolves have opened up a five-point lead. It's a one-minute timeout on Fox Sports Pueblo. Seven to play here in the fourth quarter. Thunderwolves lead it by five. Thunderwolves up to 35% now from the field. Mines still mired down at 27%. Thunderwolves with 18 turnovers, Ordiggers with nine. That's the number that's kind of the bugaboo right now for the Thunderwolves. They can just clean up their play here down the stretch. Ordiggers so good in close games. They won 13 in a row. Here's Tyree. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Looking for a screen. Dribbles around it. Into the paint. She's surrounded. Comes outside. Onto the left wing. Down low. Martin turns at the buzzer. It's a shot clock violation as she shot an air ball. Good defense by Molly Rohr. And it was a chance to build on it right here with 3:52 to go. Inbounds pass to Arietta. Arietta now will bring it across the timeline for the pack. Is it off to Piper? Piper inside to Rohr. Backs her way into the paint. Goes up with the right hand. Hook missed it. Piper tap try. No good. And the rebound on the baseline. Belongs to Call Morgan. Is it up top to Tyree? Tyree works around a screen. Tule Sue went for the steal. Couldn't quite secure it. Jim Turgeon thought it might have been deflected off the Mines player. I didn't have a clear enough view to go that far. Inbounds pass to Tyree. Dribbles around a screen. In from the left goes up. Right-hander missed it. Rebound loose in the corner. Chased down by Martin. Comes up top. Only 10 on the shot clock. Three-pointer on the way. Short. Tule Sue has the rebound on the baseline, and she's fouled. And the foul will be on Call Morgan, and she's gone. Fifth foul on Anacall Morgan. More importantly, Tule Sue Anderson gets to walk down the entire length of the court and shoot free throws here. It was a great rebound by Tule Sue flying in from the right side. Oh, Anderson at the line. 7 of 8 from the stripe tonight. 3:13 to go here in the fourth quarter. Spins it up with the right hand and rattles it in. 50-44. Thunderwolves on a 6-0 run here. Tule Sue taking her time here. Almost like you can just sense every point. So critical down the stretch. She hits them both. She has 19. It's 51-44. Thunderwolves by 7. Tyree across the timeline. Holds things up. Onto the right side. Here's Bailey, the freshman. Down low. Turning. Facing. Right-hand hook. Missed it! And the rebound to Rohr off the miss by Martin from point-blank range. Hand it off to Arietta, and she'll bring it across the timeline. We're down to 2:50 to go here in the fourth quarter. Tule Sue on the right wing. Up top to Piper. Turns. Comes up top to Arietta. Arietta. Couple dribbles. Now to Anderson. Anderson now will start a drive. In from the left, layup, no, but the rebound of Martin. Gets the outlet pass to Tyree. Tyree across the timeline. Stops at the top of the key. Goes left side to Bailey. She's going to pop a three-pointer off the back iron. Tule Sue with the rebound. And now she'll hold things up wisely as Jim Turgeon had the stop sign up. Both hands extended, said, don't even think of the break. 2:20 to go. Thunderwolves by 7. Ball on the right side. Piper with it. Down low to Rohr. Rohr on the block. Wheels goes up. Foul. And the foul will be on Courtney Martin. Nope, it's going to be a help foul. Foul on Bailey. Reaching in on the help. Fourth foul on Bailey. Timeout taken by the Ordiggers. They're in big trouble here. 2:12 to go in the fourth quarter. Thunderwolves lead it by 7. It's a one-minute timeout on Fox Sports Pueblo. Thunderwolves by 7. Tule Sue Anderson to the free throw line. Sean Pooley, the assistant media relations guy for the Thunderwolves, made the trip sitting next to me, points out Tule Sue has scored the last 13 points for the Thunderwolves. It's going to be Molly Rohr at the free throw line. I beg your pardon. Free throw up and good. Molly Rohr with 16. We'll have one more. Spins it in there. 17 for Molly Rohr. 53-44. Thunderbolts lead it by 9. 2:05 to go. Here's a start drive to the hoop. Tyree feeds it in the corner. Bailey for three. Off the mark. Rebound to the baseline. Tule Sue Anderson rips it down. Now, there's Jim Turgeon with that stop sign again. Stamping on the court. Says, no, no. Runs some clock. Here's Arietta up top to Anderson. Anderson, she'll start a drive. Feeds it outside to Hine. Hine now to Arietta. 15 on the shot clock. D way outside. Get it to Anderson. Anderson drives the baseline. Feeds it outside, threw the ball away. Budge comes up with the steal. Outside to Tyree. Tyree, look out. Gets it onto the baseline to Smith. That got Tyree. Three-pointer on the way. Short. Rebound to Hine. Gets the outlet pass to Arietta, and Arietta will just slow things up, and they reach out and foul her in the backcourt. The foul will be on Tyree. Get the feeling that might be all she wrote.
Foul by number 10, for Tyree, first second.
Down to a minute 24 to go here in this fourth quarter. Arietta from the line, free throw good. She'll have one more. It's a 10-point lead for the Thunderwolves. On the way. That one too hard. So it's a 10-point lead, a minute 20 to go. Tyree feeds it onto the right side to Budge. Budge to Tyree, drives into the paint, goes up, little running right-hander, good. Nice move there by Laura Tyree. She has nine, it's 54-46. No time to relax. Here's Arietta on the right side, gives it up top to Piper. Now to Hine, now to Tule Sue. Looks like the Ordiggers were just trying to foul, but now they don't. Now they do foul outside, and that's Cassidy Budge. The reason she didn't want to foul, because that's going to be all. She fouls out of the ball game. And stepping to the line, Tule Sue Anderson, 19 points in the game. Free throw good. All of her points here in the second half. Unbelievable. Timeout taken by the Ordiggers. 57 seconds to go. Thunderwolves by 9. It's a 30-second timeout on Fox Sports Pueblo. Thunderwolves lead it by 9. Tule Sue Anderson with one more free throw to come here. She has 20 in the game. Here in this fourth quarter. We throw up and rattles it in. 56-46. Thunderbolts by 10, under a minute to go. Here's Tyree in a hurry, or outside, rather, to Kuhn. Kuhn gives it off to Tyree, jacks up a three ball off the back iron. Hine lost the rebound, and it comes right to Kuhn, and she lays it in. 56-48, long inbounds pass. Tule Sue chases it down in the forecourt. They try to foul her, and now they finally reach out and grab her. Foul will be on Husa. Or I said Husa. I think it's Husa. No, it is Husa. Okay. With your first instinct, I guess. Two more free throws here for Tule Sue Anderson. On the way, and she finally missed one. And the fans celebrate like it's some grand achievement. One more for Anderson. Spins, that one looks short. And a rebound chased down by Arietta. And then she is fouled. Or is the ball going out of bounds? They got to call a foul, I believe so. Tule Sue with those two free throws could have matched a career high. Maybe that's saving it for tomorrow, perhaps. And it'll be Arietta to the free throw line. 6 points in the game. Free throw up and good. One more for the senior, the former Cyclone out of Pueblo West. She has 8, 58, 48. Thunder rolls by 10. We're down to 35 seconds to go in a hurry. Here's Kuhn. Top of the key, starts to drive down the lane. And shot no, but a foul on Tule Sue Anderson. Now stay with us for our post-game show. Sean Pooley will nicely give up his seat so we can do our post-game interviews. He's that kind of guy. Free throw good by Katie Kuhn. She'll have one more. On the way, swish. 58-50. Thunderwolves by 8. Inbounds to Tule Sue. Foul in the backcourt. They might have fouled Arietta. Yep. D tried to get rid of the ball in a hurry, but they reached out and grabbed her. And the foul will be on Kuhn. So Arietta here with a couple of free throws. A chance to get into double figures if she can hit a pair. First toss up, and it's off the back iron. No good. D struggles from time to time from the free throw line. Kind of one of the weirdest things. 56% this year. Hits the second. 59-50. We're under 30 seconds to go. Here's Kuhn in a hurry. Stops and pops for three. It hits the backboard and the iron. No good. Tyree into the corner. Here's Husa. Air ball. Rebound on the backside to Toman. Comes outside. Three-pointer by Bailey. Back iron. No good. Rebound. Loose. Roar has it and then threw it away. Into the corner. Here's Bailey. Feeds it up top. Toman for three. It's off the back iron. No good. And finally, Piper restores order with a rebound. 3 seconds to go to Hine. Outlet to Arietta. And that will do it. Thunderwolves win it. 59-50. Back with our post-game show. We'll talk to Jim Turgeon as well as our star of the game. It'll be Tule Sue Anderson. Who else? What a second half she had. Thunderwolves win it 59-50 on Fox Sports Pueblo. Thunderwolves win it 59-50. We wait our post-game guests. It'll be Tule Sue Anderson and Jim Turgeon. That's all to come your way. Let's recap the ball game. Thunderwolves got off to a horrendous start in this game. They led it 2-0, but then the Ordigers scored 13 straight, led it 13-2. Thunderwolves got the final three of the first quarter, trailed 13-5 at the end of one. And the Thunderwolves slowly started to slug their way back in the ball game. Got it within four on three different occasions. Ordigers did hit the final three-pointer of the first half, led it 27-20 at halftime. They got the first bucket of the second half, led it 29-20. Then the Thunderwolves started to come. They hit a couple of three-pointers, got it within seven at 33-26. Kept the run alive, got it to within two at 33-31. Teams traded hoops, but then the Thunderwolves got the final five of the quarter, led it 36-35 as we headed to the fourth quarter. Then the Thunderwolves and the Ordigers traded hoops three times. Thunderwolves led it 42-41. Ordigers then tied it with a three-pointer at 44-44. But then Tule Sue Anderson just took over this ball game. Thunderwolves went on a 10-0 run, led it 54-44. Continued to hit their free throws down to stretch, and they stretch it out to a 9-point victory. 59-50 is the final. Back with our guests right after this on Fox Sports Pueblo. Welcome back to Lockridge Arena. Thunderwolves win the ball game 59-50. And joining us, our star of the game, Tule Sue Anderson, finishes the game with 21 points tonight. All of them in the second half. At one point, Tule Sue, you scored 13 in a row, put the team on your back, and kind of carried them to victory. Talk about the ball game.
It was a tough one, honestly. They were way better. I mean, they are undefeated. Like, they deserve that, but it was definitely a battle. They're a really good team, and I think once we went into the locker room and Coach kind of ripped us a new one, we were like, we definitely got to step up. We cannot let this team beat us, out tough us. We definitely deserve this one. We've been preparing all week for it. We've been battling injuries. I've been battling an injury, so I knew I had to get back and be healthy for my team.
Well, I talked to a couple people at halftime, mainly the main boss, Joe Fold, at halftime. I go, man, we got to get Tule Sue going.
Yeah.
I go,
you
got to keep this ball club. But if you don't score, the team doesn't score, it seems like. But in the second half, and it all predicated on your ability to drive the ball to the hoop. You hit a three, I think, got you going, it seemed like. But then the drives of the hoop is what is the key to your offense.
Yeah, I absolutely love driving to the basket. My coach always told me, there's not no one in this league can guard you. So you better take it to the rest. But within the offense, I'm like, okay, I got you.
It's kind of a fine line doing that sometimes,
yeah.
Isn't it? I know. If I was the boss,
yeah,
which we're thankful where I'm not, but, you know, I would say, you know what, we gotta let Tule Su explore a few things,
yeah,
out there. You get that feeling sometimes, like, oh no, you almost know when you're gonna get the hook sometimes,
yeah,
don't you?
Yeah.
But when they let you run free and get things going, it seems to feed off, and everybody else gets going then.
Yeah, coach specific, when he runs those plays for me, that just gets me going. I'm like, oh yeah, this chick's about to get her ankles broken, or something's about to happen, but I know you are not about to guard me.
Well, yeah, and let's talk about Molly Rohr tonight. Great
wow.
Game. You know, she had the struggle in the game against Black Hills,
yeah,
or against South Dakota Mines, I guess it was, with her sister. I know I probably felt bad for her in that ball game, but has really bounced back the last two ball games. Pretty,
yeah,
good efforts.
Yeah, I have no, there's not really any words I can say about Molly. Molly is absolutely amazing. If I get beat, I know I got Block City down there, so, but I am so happy. I can't even talk right now. I absolutely love her, adore her. Her work ethic is amazing. There's not anyone in this league that can guard her, as you guys can tell. I mean, the girl that we played against, she's a great player, but just not quite good enough for Molly.
All right, tell everybody at home hello. And
hi, everyone. Thank you. Hi, Mom, my dad, Kobe there, McKay, Grandma, Grandpa.
Go. Stay right here while we go to break. We'll be back after this timeout with Jim Turgeon, hopefully, if TV lets him go on Fox Sports Pueblo. Welcome back to Lockridge Arena. Thunderbolts win the ball game 59-50. And joining me now, I'm sure and obviously elated, Jim Turgeon winning the ball game 59-50. After a quarter, Jim, it was a kind of gut-wrenching for a while there.
What did we have? 5 points?
5 points.
I think we had more air balls than we had points. I know we definitely had more. We had 8 turnovers first quarter, too. Second quarter was a little bit better. Second quarter, we still weren't executing, but we started to compete a little bit. And at halftime, we just talked about doing our stuff. Just settle down and play together, talk on the court, and, you know, the girls just did it.
You worked hard to get it within 4, I think, about 3 or 4
gosh,
different occasions there in the second quarter, and then they got that final hoop at the,
yep,
end of half, and then the, you know, jumper to get the start the second half. You're down by 9, but refused to fold. Really just kind of reeled them in and then,
yep,
took over.
Well, absolutely. You know, once we calmed down, I've been telling the girls all week and tonight that they weren't going to just give us the game. We had to go take it. And first half, we just were, I don't know what was wrong, but we took it. I mean, we made plays. The girls played together, and that's how you beat a great team like that, is you got to go take it, because they're not going to give you anything.
Well, I think in that first half, too, they showed they have pretty quick hands on their,
yep,
defense. They were getting in there, knocking a lot of balls free. It was hard,
yep,
to really get anything going, but the second half seemed like a little stronger with the ball, and I think that was key.
We were stronger with the ball, better spacing on offense. I think we had the lanes to drive the first half, too, but they were collapsing a little bit. We didn't read our reads very good. We always talk about in your lane, out of the lane. Girl would get in our lane, and we'd still try to score instead of kicking it out. And I thought the second half our spacing was a little better, and I took a little bit more control the second half. I slowed our team down a little bit, and we ran more sets, and I think that helped us a little bit, too.
I think it's good for your ball club, too, to win a couple of the last two ball games, a couple grinder games.
Yeah.
It would lower scoring ball games. Earlier in the year, it seemed like you were getting the best of people, beating them, blowing them out, but,
yeah,
now to win a couple close games, huge.
Well, it's gigantic, and probably the rest of the conference games against the, you know, could be anybody, but particularly the better teams in the conference, they're probably going to be grinders. I mean, I don't want to play that way, but maybe that's the way we need to play. You know, we play the hell out of the defense and try to rebound. And we beat a rebounding team.
Yeah.
A very, very, you saw the first quarter,
right,
how they rebound. And we came back, and you know, we got some injuries. And, you know, one I haven't mentioned is Lauren was playing in a lot of pain tonight. She has a lower back problem, and she fought through it. You know, after the first quarter, she got loose. And again, she's just another one of the warriors of this game.
And then what can you say? Well, we'll talk about Molly Rohr our first playing consistently in the pivot. After that game last Friday night, you know, a lot of the emotions going into it, a little struggle there, but last week against Black Hill State and then again tonight, you're really solid in the post.
Yeah, I don't know what the difference was today. She seemed to have a confidence about her, and I could look in her eyes and I could tell. And then same thing, I don't know if you noticed, first half we were trapping the post, and we decided at halftime, I said, Molly, can you play her one-on-one? And she said yes, and she did a heck of a job. And I don't know if you also, Molly didn't come out the second half.
Right.
And we don't want to do that, but gosh darn, she was playing so dang good, I couldn't take her out. Hopefully we can get her a little rest tomorrow night.
And then Tule Sue Anderson, what can you say about her? I mean, she turns it on, turns it off, turns it on again, and just a great second half. Just took, you know, 13 straight points there at one point.
She's a, for a coach, she's a roller coaster ride.
Right, exactly. It's a thrill ride.
Yeah, it's a thrill ride for sure. It's up and down. But I tell you what she did tonight. When she was playing poor, she kept her emotions better in check than she has in the past. And, you know, we've been working with her on a lot of different. She's a tremendous talent. It's just the emotional part of the game and making good decisions with her. And not very many kids could play that poor in the first quarter and come back and have just an incredible second half. And she has a short memory, and that's what your top scorer's got to have, is a short memory.
All right, buddy. Good job.
All right. I
Jim
appreciate
Turner, the head coach of the Thunderbolts, back with Ralph Turner right after this on Fox Sports Pueblo.